since when does ice cream make a kid scream like that? Sunday, y'all. It's our last day and I'm sad. I don't want to go back to Vegas. I don't want to go. It is Sunday, right?
Sunday.
Holy crap, I wish we would have found. Well, we found that coffee place, but we never tried it for like coffee in the morning. I don't even know what the hell we got there. Oh, you got a severely overpriced smoothie for $13. And then I went back and got a latte, remember?
Yeah.
And then, but today we got Americanos from that place, and that coffee was so good. We've been standing in that stupid ass Marriott Starbucks line for like 30 minutes every morning. They charge me 50 cents for cream for the damn coffee. And we should have been going to that place every day.
Yeah.
But that's all right. Now it's, what time is it?
I have no idea.
Let's see what time it is. What time it is? What time? It's 10:52 in the morning. It's 10:52 in the morning. We slept in until 8 a.m. this morning. Woo! Late sleepers. We went down, got the coffee. Now we're gonna walk down. I think we're gonna walk down to the South Point. Is it a pier?
Yes.
Is it South Point Pier?
Yes.
We're gonna get out and wander about Miami Beach today. No rental cars, none of that, because we don't have it no more. Maybe we get a bicycle.
No.
I enjoyed the bikes. Those bikes are kind of rough though. They're not comfortable. They really are just for transportation, not for leisure. But if we lived here, or if we lived in South Florida at a beach town, we would definitely have to get a couple super comfortable bikes that we could ride around. That shit was fun. I enjoyed it. I wish I had my damn boosted board here. This town was made for boosted boards.
I'm floating.
Yeah. Well, that's all right.
Yeah, buddy.
Got a little bit of pier action going out here with the troopers. Troopers on a mini pier, a tiny little pier. nice little pier. Got the little drone and flew it around a little bit, and that was a lot of fun. I am not very good at flying the drone yet, but I got a lot better today, actually. I usually kind of freak out when I lose visual side of it, and it's so small that if it's 100 feet in the air and, you know, 100 yards away from me, it's kind of, you can't really find it in the air. So you just sort of have to trust the camera and your instincts, I guess, to a certain extent. But it was fun.
Yeah, we were out here for about an hour. And it's not that, like, the sun's not out too much.
Yeah, it's not super hot.
Yeah.
But it's getting warmer now. I'm going to go ahead and assume that the water is recycled, goes down the thing, somehow comes out, which would lead me to believe that there's pee squirting out of these things right on everyone's head. It's just a guess. I don't know for sure. I'm not going to go try to find out. Dave Portnoy lives around here somewhere. Probably about a 3 minute or 4 minute walk from where we're standing. I don't know where. But he said that Editor Pizza is, that he passes it every morning on his coffee run. I don't know where he's going to get coffee. That's a good question. Davey Page Views, where you go to get coffee in the morning. We want to know where that is. Speaking of Dave Portnoy and One Bite Pizza Reviews, he did a review for a place, I don't know, a couple of weeks ago called Call Me Gabby. And I remember he gave it a high rating.
Call Me Gabby. It's a tremendous pizza. It's an 8.3. Call Me Gabby. I don't know if you can take out.
So it was kind of on my radar, but not really. I mentioned it to Christina a few days ago. Thursday night, an elderly lady was driving her Rolls Royce, attempting to parallel park in front of Call Me Gabby, and she accidentally crashed the car into the patio outdoor dining area.
Calvin, Nicole, it was 6 o'clock in the evening when this happened. You can imagine just how packed this block was with diners.
She sent 6 people to the hospital, including a 3-year-old, and killed one person. 67-year-old chiropractor, he was trapped under the car and he died from being run over by her Rolls Royce. That's a horrible situation. And that was Thursday. We got here Tuesday night. We could have easily been there. I mean, it was kind of on the radar. And I see it every time I do searches. I see it. And I've thought, like, I don't know, maybe we go there, maybe we don't. But that's so sad for the people involved. But it's also sad for the lady, because it's definitely being reported that it was an accident. She stayed there, of course, cooperated and all that kind of stuff. I couldn't imagine having to live with that, no matter how much longer you live, right? Even if it's a year or if it's 30 years, like, I couldn't imagine living with the fact that I accidentally pushed the gas and ran over someone and killed them, and that it was just like a terror scene or something like that.
Gosh, I know.
Crazy. This is the restaurant where the accident happened the other night. All right, just a block or maybe two from our Airbnb / hotel. Hotel used to be a hotel, but now they don't rent it as a hotel. They rent it. All the rooms are rented on Airbnb, whatever you want to call it. It's a burger place called Burgermeister. And I don't know, I think it's okay. It looks like it would be all right. We're gonna go find out. Jalapeno popper action going with some cream cheese action, and we got some fritters that have bacon and mac and cheese. You like it? We like it. Crazy. Look at the size of that burger. She got La Latina. It's got pineapple, pineapple salsa, grilled queso blanco, potato sticks. Oh, that's crazy. I got a regular cheeseburger.
And that's even big.
And we're sitting here on the fence about staying here two more days. By the time you see this video, the decision will be made, but do you think we should stay two more days? This is the kind of buns I like. Big time.
Oh wow, you got some mustard action.
Yeah, that's really good. That's really good. Yeah. Just like I told you the other day, we don't pull any punches and we tell the truth. This is one of the best burgers I've ever had. It's super good. And the fries are unbelievable too. Yeah. We got the Brava style fries. They're spicy with this spicy aioli. This burger is amazing, and Christina's is too. Usually when you get crazy specialty burgers, they're not that good. When I really love a place, I really want to try stuff. I don't know why, but we got dessert coming. Those burgers were crazy. That was the... You know I don't say this lightly. I don't say this ever at all. That was the best burger I've ever had. Bobby's Burger Palace was one of the best burgers I ever had. Now, Bobby's Burgers, not so much. That burger, Bobby Flay has absolutely nothing on that burger, nothing. Bobby Flay got nothing on that burger. I mean, you know I'm not one to overhype something. That burger really was delicious. The dessert was awful. The appetizers were frozen packaged things that I didn't realize quite. When those first came out, I was like, oh man, this is not gonna be what I thought. But then the burger really, really surprised us, I think.
Yeah.
And not only that, but the people working there were super friendly.
They were.
From the very beginning.
Yeah.
From when we first walked up, like every word out of their mouth was like positive and friendly.
Oh,
sorry. Oh yeah, we can't even go in that way.
We can't?
No, I don't know. Let's just go this way. The thing is we would love to be excited about every dollar we spend every day. I would love to be able to tell you that every place we eat is fantastic. Unfortunately, in 2022, the majority of places are not fantastic and not worth the money. That's why people think I complain. They think I complain because I tell the truth. But when I said Le Thai was unbelievable and everything we've ever had there was really good, when I tell them about the other places, some people don't hear that. They only hear me tell the truth about the places I don't like. And then they say I complain all the time. Complain, complain, complain. Maybe that's why those people get 400,000 views telling you that Sandwich Day Miami is the best thing they've ever eaten.
What? Yeah. Dog poop.
I thought you said you gotta poop. Is that dog shit? Did you not clean your shit? let me put you right on YouTube. I'm gonna put you on the internet, sir. You and that dog's stinky ass. This is our new spot. Gelato Go.
Gelato Go.
Americano. Yo, guess what? Our flight is tomorrow.
Our flight was canceled.
We canceled it. We're flying back on Wednesday instead. Two more days.
What? Crazy.
I didn't know that Southwest, there's no charge. No charge to change your flight. All you do is pay the fare difference. And guess what? Our fare difference was -$33. So we got $66 back.
Win-win.
Win-win. We spending money, but still, we didn't spend that much. I mean, we're already over here. You know, we've been really on the run the whole time. I think we should relax a little. That's why we're at Gelato Go.
We're gonna relax. We're gonna have a...
What?
We're gonna relax. We're gonna have a... What is it called? Cannoli?
Cannoli. We're going to sit right here. I'm gonna edit part of my vlog as we kick back to the sounds of Miami in the background.
All the horns. All the horn blowing.
It's called a working vacation. Editing right out here in the ocean breeze.
You can feel it too, it feels good.
I know.